as you mentioned, half caste. Well, I wouldn't use that term, but you're somebody who comes from the best of both worlds, I would think. I do know other people who are also half Indian. And I know that their approach to anything Indian comes from a very different perspective. And I think they are more Indian than any of us could ever be, I think, also. I just wanted to ask you a little bit from her perspective on what was your background in learning and what were some of the challenges you faced and what do you think is good or bad, or maybe not using those terms, but what do you think are the pros and cons of teaching Indian classical dance today, or the circumstances in which people learn today?
Okay. So the pros and cons of being multiracial?
Coming from that background, yeah. I just want to hear your perspective on what do you think are the pros and cons of a school? Like, for example, we heard about the whole Gurukulam method, okay. Right? Okay. And how it's not like that now. So it's more studio-based.
Yeah.
So what is your take on that?
I think that right now, well, having lived in Chennai for 10 years, I go back every year and I see what it's like. I feel in the city that I come from, Perth, we've recently in the past 7 years had a large increase in Indian immigrants.
Okay.
So the Indian community, when I was growing up in Perth, like Gidijas probably see me running around in my like chaddis, because we were all of like 30 families. The whole Indian community knew each other. If you didn't say hello to an auntie in a shopping center, you went home and you got a whack. Like, I grew up in that kind of small-knit Indian community. Now when I go home and I go and teach at my Athe's dance school, I feel like, as much as we're saying that it's a wonderful thing that people get Indian culture through Indian dance, now parents feel it is no way their responsibility. They think, well, I'm paying you $20 an hour to teach my child, make them Indian. And that's impossible, because how do you teach someone a dance form, philosophy, religion, language? Some lady asked me why her daughter couldn't speak Tamil after 2 classes. I was like, where do I have the time? Where do you have
it's
the time to do
class.
All of these things? Yeah, I mean, right now what's happening is that it is a wonderful thing, and it is a wonderful thing to learn culture through art. But right now I think that parents are giving up on that job. Okay. I mean, my mom was English. My mom was English, as I've talked about. But my mom never... My mom learned the stories to tell me the stories of Krishna. It's not like my mom was like, here's a book, read it. I didn't grow up with my paternal grandparents, so I didn't have like a party to like fuss over me or anything. And my mom did a perfectly good job. Like, she learned the stories, and I mean, she learned dance, so she brought me up with Indian traditional values. If you look at me and my sister, we're like chalk and cheese. I can speak Tamil, we'll say. I can eat with my hands. My sister can't, she doesn't like India. She was just here and she just complained it was hot all the time. So, I mean, within one family, you can't expect everyone to be the same, but my thing is that you can't push culture through one avenue alone. It comes through a lot more things. And I think that diasporic families now just go, well, dance is the answer to that. And it isn't, because you know what? When you grow up with family values like traditional Indian families do, you do grow up with that. If that's missing, dance isn't going to do a lot. Dance is just one thing of many things that can make culture grow.
Thank you. Anusha, since you have taught in London, yes, I would like to know what is your take on this in terms of the current scenario. Like, okay, we heard about Australia, we saw about it in the video as well. But what would your take be in terms of youngsters learning Indian classical dance currently? What is their approach to it? What are their feelings towards it? Both from a professional standpoint or from somebody who just comes for class. You can take it from whichever angle you would like to approach it.
Girija, or anyone who's there, can we show the short video that I have? Turn around. Just very quickly turn around. So that's me and my student, and we made a piece called Color Contact for outside spaces. The first place it was performed was the London Underground. I was so chuffed that instead of train timings, it was Bija Dance Company performances in the museum. I'm showing you just few bits. Performance in the Natural History Museum. Tim is an opera singer. We've got a couple of actors. You haven't seen a host, a lot of musicians as well. This was a short piece performed off-site. Dance pieces that I made with community groups. And you can see it's a really mixed community group. And I've made work, and this is exciting about Britain. We make work as dance artists with community, performing besides communities. Performing with professional artists, amateur artists, non-professionals, children, adult, disabled. This is creating pieces of work that I performed within daycare centers. So the range of work that I've done as a dance maker in the UK is quite varied. Performances in hospital, and you don't see musicians that also surround the work. This is a piece of work that we made for people with dementia. And the kind of performances I like to create is interactive, immersive, so that both the artists and the participants, the audience, have an experience of dance. And this is a piece that was an hour-long dance piece. My youngest dancer was 62 and the oldest 94.
Love it. Love rock and roll. Love it. Love it. Love rock and roll. Love it. My house was a teddy boy. He had blue suede shoes. I had rock and roll skirts, you know, the big heels and everything. Go on his motorbike, go to do.
Stopping short, listening. Was that the song someone was singing? Yes, from the crown of the cherry tree, for sure. There she was, relaxed and happy. Enjoy it while you can, says I. The answer was a beaming smile with eyes that twinkled, melody abound. Then in a trice, gone, and the cherry tree was empty.
Boyfriend, the smell of lilacs and the sweetness of being in love, and the very first kiss by the front door.
Swim, 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 swim